In addition to fields and methods, a class can also contain a constructor. This is a special kind of method used to initialize the object. It always has the same name as the class, and it doesn't have a return type. To be accessible from another class, the constructor needs to be declared in a section marked with a public access modifier. When we create a new instance of this class, the constructor method is called, which here sets the two fields to some default values. Note that when creating an object using the no parameter constructor, as we do here, the assignment part can optionally be left out as we have done before, but to pass arguments to the constructor, we have to include it. Just as with any other method, we can overload the constructor with different parameter lists. For example, with these two constructors, we can now initialize the object either with no arguments or with two arguments, which will be used to assign the fields. Inside of the constructor, as well as in other methods belonging to the object, we can use a special keyword called this, which is a pointer to the current instance of the class. If we, for example, use the same parameter names as the field names, we could still access the fields by using the this pointer, even though they are overshadowed by the arguments. As an alternative to assigning fields inside of the constructor, they may also be assigned using the constructor's initialization list. This list starts with a column after the parameter list and is followed by calls to the field's own constructors. This is actually the recommended way of assigning all fields, because it gives better performance than assigning them inside of the constructor. If we don't define any constructors for a class, the compiler will then automatically create a default constructor with no parameters when the program compiles. Because of this, we can instantiate a class even without implementing a constructor. The default constructor will only allocate memory for the object. It will not initialize the fields. Fields in C++, just as with local variables, are never assigned default values automatically. Instead, they will contain whatever garbage is left in that memory location until we explicitly assign them values.